Hello dear students, lesson 7, importance of water. Already I have explained you everything related to this. Now we will start with the exercise. So here I have written the answers. Water helps in digestion of food in animals. So water is helping in all sorts of digestion in animals, whatever food we are eating. Then second, animals living in water are called as aquatic animals. Then animals which can live both in water and land are called as amphibious animals. Water trapped between underground rocks is called as groundwater. Dash and dash are aquatic plants. So we have so many examples given. So you can write any two examples for that. Here you can see so many examples are given. So you can write any two examples related to this answer. Then we have exercise B, true and false. Water is required for germination of seeds. It is true. Groundwater can be drawn by hand pump. True. About 50% of water is present in seas and ocean. That is false. Then octopus is an amphibious animal. That is also false. It is an aquatic animal. River water is purified for drinking purpose. That is true. Tick the correct option. About 97% of water is present in seas and ocean. So here it is the correction to the statement. Not 50% but 97%. Now we come on second one. Plants absorb water from the soil with the help of roots. A rehat is used for drawing out ground water for irrigation. An example of amphibious animal is frog. Means it can live both on land and water. Now we come on the exercise. Name two water bodies that exist on the surface of the earth. So we have on page number 70 water bodies. Here you can see I have marked rivers, ponds, lakes, streams and glaciers. So you can write any two examples related to this. Then we have second question. What are the animals living in the water known as? Write names of two such animals. So animals living on land and water in water are called as aquatic animals. Okay, so here is your answer. So animals that living in water are called as aquatic animals. So here also you can write it from the keywords. So these keywords you have to write in your notebook also, as well as you can take answers from this keywords. Aquatic plants which grow in water and aquatic animals which live in water. So animals living in water called as aquatic animals. And then we have so many examples here. You can see any two you can write. Whale, seahorse, prawn, octopus. So any two examples you can write for this. Then we have another question. What are amphibious animals? So same we can take from the keywords. Here amphibious animals, animals which can live both in water and on land are called as amphibious animals. And you can write any two examples. Here are the examples given. Any two examples you can write related to this. Then we have write names of four aquatic plants. It is on page number 69. So here are names given. You can write any examples or you can write your examples on your own also. You have examples given in your textbook. Then we have how do plants absorb water from the soil. So it is again on page number 69. How do plants absorb water from the soil? Here is the answer on page number 69. Here is the answer. Plants require various nutrients for proper growth. These nutrients get dissolved in water present in the soil. Plants absorb water from the soil with the help of their roots. This absorbed water transfers the nutrients to various parts of the plant. Okay. So plants also need water for preparing their food by the process of photosynthesis. Plants require water for germination of seeds. So this is your answer. For this, how do plants absorb water from the soil? Next. State two common methods of drawing groundwater. So it is on page number 70. You can see here A step well is a well having steps on all sides. This enables people to go down and fetch water. ये one method हो गया. Next हो गया, ground water can also be drawn out and used for irrigation with the help of water wheel or a rehar. So this is your answer to the question number 6, that is D6. अब हम E part पे आएंगे. Besides its domestic use, state three other uses of water. अब ये आपको लिखना है own words में. So you have to write on your own this answer कि पानी के और क्या क्या uses हो सकते हैं. Now next, how does water help in excretion of waste material from animal bodies? So here you have your answer on page number 68, animal bodies. Here is the answer. All animals drink water. This helps them in digesting their food. This complete paragraph is your answer E2. Okay? So this will be your answer E2. Now we come on E3. List any four ways in which water is important for plants. Again page number 69. How water is important for plants. So ye hamara ho gaya. Isme se aap ways likhoge plants likhoge various nutrients for ye aap point wise likhoge ab. It is helping the nutrients which helps the plants for proper growth, then it helps in the process of photosynthesis, it helps to transfer the nutrients to various parts of the plants. Okay, so this is the way you will write the same answer but in points 1, 2, 3, 4. Then how can groundwater be drawn out through tube wells? Ab tube well mein se kaise hoga? Come on page number 71. So here is the tube well one answer. Groundwater is drawn out using tube wells. Ye complete jo paragraph hai groundwater se leke electric pump tak. Ye ho gaya hamara answer ye wala E4. Okay. Now what is a step well? Page number 70. वही हुआ step well जो हमने D6 answer mark किया था, यही हमारा होगा E5 answer भी. How is water supplied in cities? Page 71. How is water supplied in cities? ये जो है पूरा answer आएगा, पूरा paragraph. This will be your answer. How is water supplied to cities? That is your E6 answer. Okay, so children, write all these things in your notebook very, very neatly, clear handwriting, neat and clean work, and then send me within 5 days. I am giving you 5 days, complete all the question answers. Thank you. Have a nice day.